in the sky. I'm high above the world I used to know, and I'm far from any danger.
Hey, good to see you again. Feels like just yesterday. So here we are, the beginning of this wonderful trip, and we're sitting in the school lineup, waiting to get Ryan. Once we get him, we gotta pop back into town and go to the other school and get the other two. And then we can head on up. Yeah. Alright, here we are at the Hannaford in Westbrook. We got a little dinner, got some meds, and we're just heading on up there. About an hour and 14 minutes away, and we're just gonna pray that the good old Jeep here makes it, because we got a CV joint gone and the transmission's slipping. So we're gonna get up there and we're gonna have a great weekend. On a positive note though, I wanna thank this woman right here. Without her going to work as hard as she can to keep everything going while we go off and live life, none of this would be possible. So, let's enjoy.
Safe from any failure, guarded, I found shelter in the storm. I'm hiding in the blue, safe between the clouds. Was a soldier in the legions, fought against.
And we have arrived. Can't be all that bad, right? Well, good morning there. Here we are, day one. Bright and clear this time.
So much better. It's the best.
So far this morning, it's been very, very busy around here. We've had loons calling. We've had bald eagles flying over.
I saw a fish.
A chipmunk fish.
I saw a fish go down.
And a seaplane take off right in front of the campsite. What will the day bring us? What you did miss last night during all the fun setting up again in the dark was our table split completely in half. Which that turns into one of these slide-out beds, so we've improvised. We're using these food bins to hold it up until I can get home and build a new table to put in here. You only live once, right?
The demons fought against the monsters made of gold, but they stormed across Arcadia, following the nature, washed away the place I once called home. I'm hiding in the blue. In the blue, where I can't be found, I'm hiding in the blue.
How you doing? We've wandered on down through Booth Bay Harbor, through town, found a few nice coffee shops, various things that we should try. And we're now at a park here, so let's enjoy this. I just want to take a moment and thank this beautiful woman right here, because of her, we get to visit Booth Bay Harbor. And just so you're all aware, this is the view from the adult suite. Well worth it. Ah, yes, it's a beautiful day here on the lake. Let's talk about a few of the things that we are now without from this trip due to various things. Look, the kitchen table and the camper snapped in half. While Ryan was swimming with flippers, he lost a flipper, so we now need to buy a new set. While they were using the hammock, it split in half, so we're out of hammock.
Hey, it wasn't my fault.
It's been a very expensive trip. We just might have the most private site on the whole campground.
Hi, Dad.
It's actually very nice. Mm-hmm. Speaking of which, I don't think I've had my guy enjoying a half and half Romano Palmer Park. There is nothing better. As evening draws in over here by the lake, we're about to cook up some dinner. We don't really know what. We're thinking maybe scrambled burger with onions, tacos, who knows. But there's a nice breeze brewing. It's gonna be a good night. And tomorrow, it's time to head on home. And welcome to our normal segment of Can You Smell That? No, You Can't. Oh, it's gonna be good. Morning there. It's coming up on 10 o'clock here on our final day at the Duck Puddle Campground. Took a wander up to the store, spent a lot of money on a couple nice cups and some ice cream at 9:30 in the morning, and now we're just going to hang around a little bit, maybe have some lunch, and then we're going to pack up and head on home. Let's just hope the trailer and the Jeep make it. This is nice. And so ends our trip to Duck Puddle Campground. It is really a fairly nice campground with the water sites, and there's some things to do. Unfortunately, our stay wasn't longer, but we gotta get back on the road and head on home because we got school and work in the morning.
Hurry up, though, it's dripping.
And the boy's doing the trash.
Sorry.
Let's just pray the Jeep and the trailer make it home without issue. See you on the other side. It really, it just would not be the end of a camping trip without traffic. At least we're in a beautiful place.
Between the clouds in the blue, where I can't be found, I'm hiding in the blue.
Well, here we go. We made it home safely, thankfully. Thank God, no issues with the truck or trailer. But I can honestly say that will be the Jeep's last trip, and it will not be making the trek to Acadia in a couple weeks. It was a really nice campground, surprisingly nice. I really wish we had more time to prepare. It was a little ill preparation for that one. Could have had a lot more fun. Would have done a lot more things had we not had transmission and CV joint problems. So we're going to try to go back to that one. But for now, that's all she wrote. We'll see you the next time.